Welcome back, nail crew. So in this video, I will be going into detail on the pop-off method. So all your questions, I got you, okay? I got you. Now, before we get into that, let's give a hey, girl, hey, to my girl, C-Mayo. C-Mayo had her reminder set. Thank you, girl. That means a lot. She is not trying to miss a video, you guys. She said, nope, I got reminder set, and we are ready to roll. So thank you, girl. Thank you. I appreciate it. All right, so we are going to start the peel off or the pop off method the same way that we would do any other method. We are going to push back the cuticles, okay? That's pretty standard, so nothing new there. Then we are going to pull out our cuticle drill bit. Now, the one that I'm using looks like this, but I have plenty cuticle drill bits, and whatever is working for you, continue to use that one, okay? You do not have to rush out and get this one. Whatever's been working for you, continue with that. So now that we have the cuticle drill bit in our e-file, we are just going to remove the dead skin that's been left on the nail plate, okay? So you use that cuticle pusher. There were some things that you couldn't push back, right? There's some sticky cuticle on the nail, some protein buildup on the nail. We are going to use our tiny cuticle drill bit to remove it. So once we're done with that, we can switch over to an arbor band. If you don't feel comfortable with an arbor band, you could replace it with your ball bit, whatever you feel comfortable with, okay? But the point of this step is to just remove the shine from the nail plate. Now, the reason I'm using an arbor band versus the ball bit is because the ball bit is smaller, so I would have to do more strokes to remove the shine. Does that make sense? So although the ball bit would probably be better for the nail plate and very, very good for a beginner to use, it will just take too much time because it's so small. So basically, to save time, I'm using a larger drill bit, okay? But use whatever is in your comfort level. So now that the shine has been removed from the nail plate, we are going to put in our ball bit, and I want you guys to pay attention to this. We are going to switch from forward position to reverse, and we are also going to turn down the rotation, okay? The RPMs, we're going to turn that way down. And again, we are in the reverse position. So before, we were going right to left, but now we are going left to right. So we're going to mix it up a little bit. And I really just like to use the ball bit as my polisher, if that makes sense. I like to polish everything up with my ball bit. And I want you guys to notice that it is so mild that you could definitely take care of all your hangnails, the calluses that form on the side of your nail. You could use a ball bit to get right on your skin. Look at this, you guys, look at this. I have it on my skin. It doesn't hurt. It doesn't hurt at all. It is so mild. You can get right on the hangnails and remove them. You can sand away your calluses, all that with a really good ball bit. All right, you guys, so once we are done with the ball bit, you could put away your e-file and your drill bits. We are ready to move on. So I have in this bottle alcohol and acetone. Oh my gosh, this is a lot, but I use this stuff all the time, okay? I also have a scrub brush, and if we were doing a permanent prep, then I would be using primer, but today we are not. We are using base coat, okay? So do not get confused. We are not using primer today. So now let's clean away all the dust we just created with our e-file, okay? And we are just going to spray on our alcohol and acetone solution. Use our scrub brush to really just brush away all the lint and dust that we just created on the nail. Now, once that's done, remember we would normally go in with primer, but not today. Today we are going in with cuticle oil, okay? And the way that we are prepping today, this is the same way that I prep to do my left hand and my right hand. Now, my left hand, I have been wearing these nails for the last 6 days and they still have not come off. I'm trying to do a little experiment to see how long they will last, so I will keep you guys posted. Now, once the cuticle oil is on the nail, all you do is grab your base coat and apply the base coat right on top of the cuticle oil. This is going to create a peelable base coat, okay? This is our DIY peel off base coat. So if you already have peelable base coat, well, obviously you do not need to do this, but if you do not, this is a great hack. Now, if you do not want oil in your base coat, just grab a lint-free wipe and wipe your brush off before you stick it back in the bottle. And that way your base coat is not contaminated. What I do is I just have a base coat that I only use for this method. All right, you guys. So now that the nails all have base coat on them, we are going to cure that in the lamp for a full 60 seconds. Once all the nails are cured, you can do whatever you want. Now, I'm going to be applying nail tips. I got these nail tips from the beauty supply store. They're really thick. Okay, if you like thick nail tips, these might be for you. And I love the C-curve in them. So the way that I am going to attach my nail tip today is the way that I've been doing it for the longest, okay? I like to apply my nail tips with a base coat. I do not like glue. If you like glue, well, by all means, you know, use glue. But I'm going to apply my nail tips with the base coat just because this is what I'm used to doing and this is what I like to do. Now, I do have a video showing you guys four different ways to adhere your nail tips. So if the base coat method is not for you, watch this video and hopefully one of these methods will help you guys out. Now, because I did use the base coat method, I have to pop it in a lamp and cure it for a full 60 seconds. So that's what I'm doing now. Once the nails are fully cured, we are ready to file and blend. Now, remember, you guys, we just created peelable base coat. At this point, you can mess everything up. You can ruin it all. So be careful. Do not file and blend over the nail plate, okay? We are not going to touch the nail plate because you might file that peelable base coat right off and then you just wasted your time. So all we are going to do is file and blend the plastic nail tip, okay? That is all we are doing. And in fact, I do not always do this step. If I'm using thin nail tips or if I'm using clear nail tips, I really don't spend a lot of time on the filing and blending at this point because they are usually thin enough that it doesn't matter, or clear, in which case it really doesn't matter. You get what I mean? So you do not have to spend a lot of time on this part. So with that being said, I think now is a perfect time for you to check and make sure that you are subscribed. If you are subscribed, thank you so much. And if you're not subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button for more videos like this. Leave me a thumbs up and please comment below. Let me know that you are a new subscriber and let me know what videos you want to see next. Now, before I go, I do want to remind you guys, this is a peelable base coat. So once you are done, you can peel the set right off. If, however, you want a more permanent prep, then watch this video next. I will leave a link in the description box for you, okay? Until next time, guys. Bye!